Hello students, in this video I will try to explain the political tradition of Kautilya and the very famous theory put forward by him, that is the Saptang theory. So let's begin. Firstly, let us have a small introduction on who Kautilya was. So, Kautilya was a teacher at the ancient Indian University of Takshashila, and he was also known as Chanakya and Vishnugupta. The basic ideas put forward by Kautilya was regarding the origin of state, nature of the state, concepts of dharma and danda, interstate relations and diplomacy, welfare state and public opinion, the social structure which consists of the Varna system and the Ashram system, and 34 different departments of the government. The magnum opus of Kautilya, the Arthashastra, contains a commentary on economics, ethics, sociology, intelligence, espionage, warfare, criminology, and so on. It is divided into 15 adhikarans and 180 prakarans, and it has more than 16,000 shlokas. Kautilya also talked about the different qualities a king should have. According to him, the king should have training in philosophy, economic studies, and political science. He also said that the king can achieve success or siddhi with the help of three powers of his councils. These three powers are mantra shakti, that is the strength of knowledge, prabhu shakti, that is the strength of revenue, and utsa shakti, that is the prowess. Moving on, the Saptang theory of the state is also known as the theory of seven elements or seven organs. According to Kautilya, the Saptang theory suggests that the state is a corporate entity comprising of seven elements, which are Swami, Amatya, Janapad, Durga, Kosha, Danda, and Mitra. The first organ is Swami or the king. According to Kautilya, the king should have intellect, he should be an enthusiast, he should have self-restraint or self-control, he should be from a high caste, that is the Kshatriya caste. The king should have a strong character. He should be religious and faithful and a visionary. The king should not have greed and anger and fickleness. Regarding the Amatya or the ministers, Kautilya said that the ministers should also be from a high caste family, that is the Kshatriya. They should be educated, they should have foresightedness and administrative capability, and they should have good moral character. The third organ, that is Janapada. The third organ consists of two things. The first is the territory and second is the people. So Janapada means the territory with people settled on it. Regarding the territory, Kautilya said that the land of the territory should be fertile. It should be good for cultivation. The land should not be very rocky or bushy or muddy. And the territory should have enough space for the human as well as for the cattle. Regarding the people or the citizens of the territory, Kautilya said that they should be devotees, they should have respect for the rule of law, And he also said that majority of the people should be from the caste Vaishya and Shudra, as they are the most economically productive caste. According to Kautilya, the Vaishyas consist of the traders or the businessmen, and the Shudras are the labor class. Coming to the next element, that is the Durga or the forts or the fortified capital. According to Kautilya, without forts, a king has no power, and the king should have four types of forts in their country. These four types of forts are: number one, hill fort; number two, water fort; number three, desert fort; and number four, forest fort. Next comes the treasury or the kosha. Regarding the treasury, Kautilya said that the king should have enough money to tackle any unforeseen natural or man-made calamity. He should have the ability to tackle such unforeseen emergencies without taking tax from the people. He also said that the industrial department should be under the government, and the government should give more importance to agricultural production as well as trading. With the help of these three things, the kosha or treasury can be made strong. Another advice given by Kautilya regarding the treasury is that if there's any kind of emergency, the king should not hesitate to increase the tax. Number six is the danda or the army. Kautilya said that there are six types of armies in a state. First, hereditary force. Second, hired troops. Third, soldiers of ally. Fourth, soldiers of enemies. Fifth, soldiers of fighting corporations. And sixth, soldiers of wild tribes. Amongst these six types of armies, the hereditary forces were the most reliable, they were the most loyal and experienced forces. According to Kautilya, the king should only rely on the hereditary force rather than the other five forces. The last organ of the state is ally or the mitra. According to Kautilya, there are two types of allies: natural or sahaj ally, and artificial or acquired ally or kritrim ally. Kautilya said that the king should always rely on the natural or the sahaj ally. The acquired allies are not very reliable. We have discussed the first part of the Saptang theory that speaks about the seven organs or the seven elements of the state. Now coming to the second part, which deals with the functions of the state. The functions performed by the seven organs of the state. So the state or these seven organs has four major functions to perform. Firstly, to provide protection from internal and external threats, that is, to provide protection inside the country and also protecting the country from external threats or aggression. The second major function is to maintain law and order. The third function is to preserve social order. Kautilya believed in the caste system. According to him, there should be four castes in the society: Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra, and they should preserve the social order by performing the duties that are assigned to the each caste. The fourth function of the state is to provide social welfare to the socially backward people, to women, to children, and to physically disabled. So, the basic idea of the Saptang theory is that the state is comprised of seven elements, and these seven elements all together perform these four primary or major functions of the state. Thank you.